So in this video today, I would like to explain how microorganisms are able to cause a fire. It's quite a fascinating topic. It's a mix, a complicated interaction and mix of biological and also chemical processes. But don't worry, I'm going to try to explain it in a very non-technical manner. Hi, hello, and welcome again. My name is Oliver, Microbehunter here. And in this YouTube channel that you're watching right now, I like to explore together with you the fascinating world of microorganisms and how they are able to influence our daily lives. Well, today I'm talking about a process called spontaneous combustion. It is possible indeed for microorganisms to spontaneously cause fires, especially when you're decomposing organic material. So many of us, of you maybe, I myself included, when we are collecting food scraps and grass clippings and any biological waste, and when we pile them up, then microorganisms are going to start to break down this material. And in this process, it's releasing quite a bit of heat. Now, that is called metabolic heat that's being produced. And this is a normal process. And after several weeks or months, when the decomposition process has finished, well, then you have got soil. Yeah, and that's basically the whole point of a compost, that you basically make your own soil. And in some cases, this is not made by private individuals, but actually by companies who are composting basically on a very large scale. So all of the scraps from the kitchen and the biological waste and all these things are basically collected, they're composted, and then you've got soil that's being sold. And that's a fairly common process. What's possible is that all of a sudden those compost heaps can go up in fire, in flame, because the heat that is produced by the microorganisms can actually start to cause a so-called a runaway effect that causes it to burn. However, it's, as I mentioned, not quite as straightforward, because there are a couple of interesting things here. Because you see, there are several stages that happen. Well, first of all, when you collect all of the biological waste and the kitchen scraps and everything, bacteria and fungi are going to start reproducing, and they will break it down to carbon dioxide. And this requires, of course, oxygen. However, the heat released is not going to be so much at the beginning. However, as it continues to break down, the heat inside the compost heap starts to go up. And this is when now those bacteria and fungi might start to die off, because they're not used to the high heat. And other microorganisms that are more heat tolerant, so-called, we scientists call this thermophilic, they love the heat. Thermophilic bacteria start to take over, and they are able to continue the breakdown process, and this pushes the temperature up to approximately 60 to 70 degrees centigrade. That's already pretty warm, but it is not hot enough to start a fire. Because at this temperature, at 60 to 70 degrees, what's going to happen is that even those bacteria will slowly start to die off. Essentially, the heat that's being generated kills the bacteria themselves. So it's kind of a negative feedback mechanism that you have starting here. But the question is now, how do we then get a fire, and why do those compost heaps spontaneously erupt in flame? And this is where it becomes interesting now, because in the third stage, we have now a purely chemical process taking over. The temperature is high enough for fats and also wood chippings and certain oils and so on to start to break down in the presence of oxygen on their own. So this is then basically where a purely chemical reaction starts to take place, where the remaining oxygen that's still inside the compost is used to oxidize those fats and oils. You can imagine maybe certain plant fats and plant oils that are present. Also, I read some wood chippings and clippings that have not fully broken down yet by the bacteria will then start to break down in because of the high temperature, and this will release yet more heat. And if the compost heap is large enough, then the heat cannot be dissipated and will stay inside the compost. Of course, the temperature can go up further and further. The inside will start to dry up, and then it's possible to have a fire. As a matter of fact, the situation can be quite dangerous, because if you now try to dissipate the heat by, let's say, disturbing the compost, let's say, okay, let's open it up a little bit so that the heat can escape. Well, that can be dangerous, because this causes an influx of oxygen, and then it can really start to burn. So you see, for this reason, it is really important that the core temperature of large compost heaps are continually monitored. Now, it's not only compost heaps that are facing this problem, but also haystacks. Hay is a dried grass that is harvested, then the grass is dried and stored in large piles as animal food. And the similar problem here, if bacterial decomposition starts to increase, it shouldn't, but if the hay is not properly dried, then bacteria can start to become active and break it down. Then the whole haystack can go up in flames. Yeah, and with hay, there is an additional problem. You see, as the bacteria start to grow in the hay bale, they use up oxygen, and when the oxygen level drops, the metabolism of the bacteria can change, and they will start fermenting the hay. And when they start fermenting, they have an end product called as ethanol. It's alcohol. So this basically means that as it starts to ferment, then essentially you start alcohol fumes building up. And of course, I do not have to tell you that alcohol is highly flammable and has a very low flash point. This means, yeah, a small spark is enough and everything goes on fire. It's kind of a little bit interesting and paradoxical. If you want to prevent this, you have to really make sure that the haystack is completely dry. Otherwise, if there's a little bit of moisture present, bacteria will start to grow. It's a little bit counterintuitive that actually water, or the presence of water or small amounts of water, can actually be the starting point for a fire, because the moisture and the water will actually make it possible for bacteria to reproduce. So if you want to prevent a haystack going up in flames, you got to make sure that it's really completely dry and that you do not collect the moist grass. Yeah, so you can see that it's an interesting interaction between biology and chemistry, and also maybe physics here, that we have, which allows, unfortunately, those fires to take place. And for this reason, farmers monitor very frequently the temperature, the core temperature of those haystacks. They've got a temperature probe on long probes and long sticks that are inserted into the hay, and they're measuring the temperature of the haystack to determine whether there is indeed a danger of fire or not. Well, I think microorganisms do influence our lives in quite unexpected ways as well. I would like to invite you, of course, to subscribe to this channel if you're interested in videos like this and in stories like this. From my side, that's all I would like to share with you. There is, of course, a comments section below, which is open for any comments that you might have. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting as always, and hope to see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.